And we're back, and ooh. Cool. Channeling the darkness. We're back, we are in sun and shadow, and we've got this door, and we've got stairs to go down to more of this area. The way this looks, this goes to, like, a different zone. Otherwise, I would try the door first, because I usually like to clear out a level first and, you know, then go back and open up closed or sealed doors and then go down to the level, but that icon means you're going into a new zone, so I'm just... I don't want to go to end game just yet. I mean, if... Have I been over here? I want to, you know, find all that there is in this dungeon before we continue on. I might have been over here. Oh yeah, now I'm not sure. Another Inguithin shade. Have at thee, fiend! This time we got the drop on him.
Useless.
That's not very helpful.
Well, you did barely injure it. Can we take over one? Ringleader for this one? My normal stuff here. Oh, yeah. Don't use your fist. He's a little bit of a masochist.
You can't!
Adair, just hit whoever's nearby and knock him down. Take over one of them? I don't think it worked.
Yes.
Oh, this thing's still kicking.
Damn.
Finish him off, Ayla. There you go. There's only one left? Okay. Everyone, pile on him. Yay! How many of these spirit residues do we have, I wonder? kept in here. Where are they stored? Oh, here. 107 of them. Wow. Make that 108.
Eh?
Lay low.
Got me traps here in the middle of this floor somewhere. It's just like wide open. No? Potion of Lindgrath's displaced image. I'm not sure if we keep those, if we've been keeping them. Oh, here's one. Mostly I like to stack them together just so we have room. What's it for this area, huh? Okay. Interesting. I hadn't even realized that we didn't finish this level. Oh, copper wire? Fallen warriors, apparently. Exceptional brigandine armor. And an exceptional crossbow. It's all rather exceptional. Okay.
Let's see what lies this way.
Yes, let's. You go so fast down the stairs. More figures. I can't be searched. Well, that's it? This doesn't lead anywhere? Oh. Okay. I thought there was a lot more of this area. Alright. Get this grand staircase that doesn't go anywhere. Alright, let's head through these doors then. He got stuck in the ashen statues. Lalo.
Hello.
I cut him off. New map discovered. Well, it's still sun and shadow. Oh, no fog of war. Machine over here. Interesting. So go around down these stairs, then around this way, and then in the machine, or to the machine, or at the machine. Bloodstone and a scroll of defense. Oh, here, this matches that. Oh, here's defense. It's like playing a game of concentration. I'm sure I'm not that great at it either. Gears. Oh, Morse? Wait, isn't that where I just put it? Yeah, Thaos, that's where I just put it. And, okay. There might be a couple more, but I don't know, so. It's Rolling Flame, and that's Fireball. Funny how I never use them, but I haven't. I'm holding on to all of them. Nothing? No secrets? Alright, no goodies, no secrets. Speaking of secrets, someone's whispering. Would you mind sharing with the class? Tech doesn't know. And 10 demerits for you, Buster. 2 potions of bulwark against the elements. Which is somewhere. They're whispering all around us over here. Oops! Thaos?
Are you ready to take the oath?
Here we go, guys.
To spread the word of the gods to the lost and heathen.
Okay. We cannot interact with him. Alright, got it. Can't interact. 2 Oh, 3! 3 Ring of Unshacklings? Nice. Oh. Paladino's already got one. Hannah's missing a ring, so give him one, definitely. See, what does this do? Oh, plus 10 ability area of effect. That's good for his chance, I guess. Overseeing again. Good for his spells. That's pretty good one. Plus 5 will. Helps with his spells. Well, he's got a Ring of Unshackling, a dare already. And Deflection. This is a pretty good one here. Minor Ring of Protection. Ring of Wizardry. Oh yeah, extra spell level uses, okay. And that's Gaunt's Pledge. And Ring of Deflection plus 9. Well, that's what does suppress affliction. Hmm. It's always good. I'm gonna put him in stash though. We have some pretty good rings already. This Nalcana can cast as well as Palagina and, I believe, a dare. You again? 2 rubies and 2 scrolls of major... Restore endurance? Who got that? Where'd that go? Minor endurance. Light endurance. Oh, they went here. Major endurance. Okay. Alright. What wisdom do you have to impart now?
I am trusting you to remain loyal to the gods in this.
Gods?
If you do not, you will have greater powers than me to answer to. But you will answer to me as well.
The gods are not really gods, so... I guess that's why you threw in your little Yule answer to me as well. Just in case I knew that the gods weren't actually gods. Good plan. Ooh, a broad belt of power. Pelagina has it. Plus 2 might and plus 2 resolve. Aptly named, this belt is comprised of a broad span of boiled leather joined in front by a silver buckle. Arcane spells have been forged into the material, and it grants those who wear it undeniable strength and a newfound sense of determination, which, even if it is induced, can rouse even the meekest of individuals to action. Cool. Well, we got Constitution plus 3 on this thing. That's a minor thing. How often do we get hit by criticals, since it only doesn't even take away a third of it? 0.2 move speed. It's not that great. Again. We all have this mortal protection. He has driving weight. Oh, that's what gives him knockdown. I want to keep that. I do use that quite often. It's good that, you know, at least someone other than Adair can do the knockdown thing. Only once. This movement rate bonus doesn't really mean anything to us, so... Boom! Give him this. Plus 2 might and resolve. You're welcome, Adair. And here we go again.
I wouldn't ask this. Were there any other choice?
Ask what? Not to go against the gods who aren't gods? I mean, you weren't asking us, you're basically telling us, threatening us. Or you just can't finish your sentences. Uh-huh. We can touch that. Is it even worth it to sneak in here?
This is a missionary, same as I was. Taught the wrong things as I was.
Yavara, yep. Can't interact, okay. It's a little slideshow of souls here.
Osionis. They have held off many would-be invaders.
Yep. Both.
You are ready to give a confession?
I am ready to hear one from you.
Awesome job with the voices. That's a little replay of the scene from above before we fell into the pit. Into the pit. And we can't go that way. Definitely not. Okay. People talking about something. Quest completed. I have reached the Ingwithin machine I saw in my dreams. Thousands of dear wooden souls have been drawn to it. Thaos cannot be far. The statue is warm to the touch. What about this statue? That statue is warm to the touch. Oh! Oh, there he is. You've come to a circular room, grand and domed, its walls lined with Adra and trimmed with copper. At the far end, a great pillar of Adra pierces the floor from below like a ragged spike, its shimmering texture giving the illusion of boundless depth. Your thoughts are yours and not yours, and they are all questions. At the base of the pillar stands Thaos, a look of concern on his face as he notes your approach. You have something you want to ask him, one question above all others, spinning madly in your mind, but you don't dare ask it yet. You need some admission from him first, some hint of the veracity of your suspicions. Okay.
You are far from your post, Inquisitor. What brings you here?
Your mind races, weighing different angles of approach, your emotions barely in check. So don't ask him the ultimate question yet, right? What is this place? You have a turn to choose. Okay, I'm guessing hold off on this and this. What is this place?
We are in a sanctum holy to Utica. There are others like it in service to the other gods. I come here often to pray for her counsel, and in this space I may be assured that she hears me.
That machine behind you, what does it do?
It has many uses, but its purpose is to bring structure to the chaos that surrounds it.
All these statues, who are they of?
They are monuments to Utica's greatest servants among my people. I hope to join them myself one day, but my work is not yet complete.
Was Iovara telling the truth?
That woman sought only to destroy the foundations of peace and civility that my people sacrificed everything to build.
And now, was the entire Inquisition based on a lie?
The Inquisition was based on the need to cut the flesh from a rotting wound.
You are shaking now, having lost all patience for tact. No more evasions. You have to know. Everything you believed, everything you have done for the gods. Did you lie to me when you said I would be right as long as I did what the gods would want? Thaos says nothing. Are there no gods?
What is a god? A higher power? A rewarder of good deeds and punisher of the wicked? Something men can turn to in their darkest moments when their days seem only like bridges from one tragedy to the next? Our gods are all these things.
Thaos's face remains a mask of impassivity. With Thaos's every word, you find yourself losing control of a boiling cauldron of rage and doubt and fear and hopelessness until you can take it no more. Are there no gods?
We are in a sacred place within earshot of the gods themselves. This is not the time. You've been through much these past few months.
With maddening calm, Thaos puts an index finger to his lips.
You will return home and you will rest. When you feel you have recovered, you may rejoin us at the trials. The Inquisition is far from over, and I will have need of you. There are many who continue to spread the lies of the apostate. The Inquisition will not end until we have pronounced judgment on all of them.
His eyes linger on you, and there is no mistaking the threat behind it. And your rage shrinks at the image of an iron wheel in your mind, monolithic and caked with the dried blood of thousands. You do not ask your question again. What the hell? What now? Oh. Who's this? Is that Thaos also? Or the Iovara?
How did you find it?
Huh. Well, I can attack or, I don't have a problem saying it's Lady Webb. I mean, she's dead. I didn't. It was Lady Webb.
Another in a string of acts of petty defiance. For all her knowledge, she always preferred spite over reason.
She loved you.
Then she should have obeyed. I ask one thing of all my followers. She was incapable. A waste of rare talent and intellect.
Clueless guy, she did not love you as a follower. Blind obedience is a lot to ask of someone with a mind of their own.
What of your cohorts, then? They have followed you to their deaths. Is it loyalty that brings them here? Or is it, as my agents suggest, that they have no direction of their own? You worshipped Aethys, did you not?
Thaos regards Adair.
Your spies are good. What gave me away? The cape?
Yet when your god needed you the most, you chose your country.
Adair frowns, irritated.
We were being invaded. Not by anyone who was acting like a god.
Then I should think your hometown gave you a hero's welcome when you returned.
Thaos gives a thin, patronizing smile.
They made cake. Hard to blame people for losing faith when it's the gods who are misbehaving.
The gods argue over how best to prevent Kith society from destroying itself. These disruptions would not be necessary were mortal instinct not so diseased. You have devoted yourself to studying the work of my people. Why?
Thaos has turned his attention to the big Amawa.
Because I believe we can learn from the past and use that knowledge to better ourselves. I wanted Rawatai to surpass the Angwithins, build upon what they knew.
And did you ever consider that these were things you were never meant to understand? That their comprehension is beyond you?
Oops. I don't need to understand. I've seen what's become of your people. That's all the lesson I need.
You are living in the time of my people, Amawa. You owe them more than you will ever comprehend, and so it shall ever be. Greater civilizations than yours have attempted to reclaim what we buried. The greater their successes, the worse their fates in the end. I have seen to it.
Durin stares at Thaos with a beast snarl. Thaos watches him calmly.
You built a weapon that delivered exactly as promised.
I served my goddess as you did yours.
Yet the other builders were slain. 11 of a dozen. Why not you? Were you somehow different? Redeemable in your god's sight?
Whatever desire I had to be redeemed in her eyes was weakness. Purged by the Watcher's sight.
Or was it merely that your goddess wanted you dead as well, and your delusions of importance prevented you from seeing the obvious?
A whore's beguiling charms, nothing more. But the spell's broke now, Thaos. The trial's over. I know friend from foe, and I've come here now to see a foe repaid.
You tell him, Durrance.
You were able to destroy a god because another god wished it. Without her hand to guide you, you could not strike at a god any more than you could strike the sky. You are impotent, and not just from the pox.
Does he really have that? Is he really suffering from that?
I understand your Duke's bells gave you a mission.
Theos's sudden attention causes Pelagina's feathers to ruffle.
Their orders do not absolve me of my greater responsibility to the safety and well-being of the Republics.
Adair says, you might want to skip over this one, Thaos. Don't want to pick a fight you can't win. Love it.
Yet you disobeyed. Something you already have a reputation for. They will know, of course. If it had been for a worthy cause, they might have forgiven you. But I don't see them pursuing animancy after seeing what it's done here. They trusted you, and you disappointed, as you always have. And you will again be disowned.
The parents scold, but the children are safe. Whether animancy research continues in the Republics or not, they will survive. For now, that's enough. In any case, I wouldn't be so smug about my fate, Thaos. I imagine Whitaker responds to disappointment much more severely than even my Dukes.
She takes a long step forward, a sinister smile spreading across her face.
State your name and purpose, young acolyte.
At the sight of Aeloth, Theos's mouth twitches derisively. Well, he doesn't know Aeloth.
My name belonged to the gods and my hand to their service. No more.
Aloth's eyes darken.
You serve none but yourself. Without contact with your order, you can have no higher purpose. Only the base concerns of the flesh. You have cast yourself from our ranks.
And I should have done it years before. I'd rather live in uncertainty than servitude.
And that uncertainty would lead you where it leads everyone. To doubt, to emptiness, to the many cruelties inspired by disbelief. You will have to forgive your Grandmaster for remaining skeptical of his initiate's choices. You are here because you are lost. The gods cannot reach everyone, I'm afraid. May you fare better in your next lives.
Thaos looks over your company, each one in turn. Then he directs his gaze at you.
I gather you have had your soul awakened. Why else would you shadow my footsteps like some stray mongrel? You think I have something to offer you, but our business was concluded long ago.
What do you know of our business?
You think your abilities only flow in one direction. That isn't how it works, I'm afraid. Not for me. For all that you saw of my soul in the sanitarium, I saw as much of yours.
I lived my life by the lies you told. You owe me the truth.
I answered your questions once. That your soul is not fit to accept the answers is of little concern to me. I lied to no one. Not to you, not to anyone. The gods are real. They are everything we need them to be, and the world is better for it.
A typo there. You're saying this somehow improves things?
The heart of this country has skipped a beat. Nothing more. I have done far worse. I plunged the peaceful kingdom of Telosus into civil war. I slew the monarch of Desantio, whose people never knew hardship under his rule, and replaced him with a cruel despot who brought them to ruin.
Oh, what a guy you are.
When plague arrived at the great city of Arborensis, I saw to it that the cure did not. They piled their dead outside the city in heaps that rose above their walls.
And this is supposed to somehow diminish the damage you've done here?
It is to show the proper perspective.
Well, I guess everything's relative, Guy.
There was a time, back when your soul was still a shapeless mist. When the world believed only in false gods.
Oh, like now?
Thousands of them. Gods that told them to take slaves. Gods that told them to make war upon their neighbors and devour the slain. Gods that told them to burn their children alive and cover themselves in the ashes as a sign of their faith. But all that changed when they learned of the true gods. Our gods. All those misshapen, bestial instincts melted beneath the radiance of our God's majesty. You could see it in their eyes. That dull emptiness replaced with the glimmer of a kindled spark.
Well, just as number three talks about leading them, I want to lead him into telling us the truth through this conversation. You led them to overcome their nature.
No person can overcome his instincts by himself. Only with the aid of a god, someone he will respect and listen to, even against his every impulse, does he stand a chance. Have you imagined this existence? The one the apostate would have created? We are not all so virtuous as she. Without our gods, the most wicked, the most tyrannical, they would take that power for themselves. But more than that, it would be a hollow existence. All mysteries forever unanswered. All purposes constructed from meaninglessness. No endings to bring closure. Only a wheel turning without mercy, grinding our spirits to dust.
Oh, sorry, guys. Ugh. I don't want to agree to him the whole way and then end up, I don't know. I just want to lead him towards telling us the truth. Without joining him. as the game would consider, okay, you join Thaos and... Okay, I don't know if it can, but I don't want to lead it that way. Better that than to live a lie.
Telling yourself each day that what you do matters, that it isn't all for nothing, that the world is just. The apostate's world is built on believing lies. All I have seen, the millennia of experience. I will not be dissuaded from this course. This is the only way.
Wow, I'm really deliberating between one and two. You really think he'll admit it? I don't think he'll admit it. I mean, I do like the idea of choosing this, I just don't think that he will admit it. But if we bring in doubts, perhaps make him doubt further. You are blind to think yours is the only way. You are controlled by your own doubts.
We are all controlled by our own doubts. Better that we should be relieved of them. With your soul and thousands of others, I will see this world purged of its suffering. Hear me, Woodica. Your servant calls for aid.
Oh, crap. Scary music! Thaos puts his hands out low to either side, as though welcoming some unseen guest. He shuts his eyes and casts his face skyward. Maybe we should choose number one.
Rock 10!
Ooh! That's not good. Oh, hello. Whitaker's headsman. And Whitaker's judge. And Thaos. Oh my god. Crap. Hope we can survive this, guys. Integration. We'll try to, I don't know. Actually, we should probably head for this one. That. Piercing Burst. I don't know if we could possibly knock things like that down. Guess it's worth a try. Durance is shortly going to be busy with healing. Oh, they're attached already. Alright. Already injured. Already passed, barely damaged. That's good news. Try to take it down. Have him heal her once he's done. Oh my god. Okay, did she cast her spell? Yes, she did. Golan's pledge and heal. Oh my god, you haven't cast that yet? Yeah, both of these two. What's going on with her? Oh, she's at zero, duh. Oh my god, and Aloth's at zero? Well, this thing's at least almost dead. Not good. Not good at all. Exhortation for her. He's dead. I don't know what else to do. We don't have anything. I'm surprised Durance doesn't have a spell for that. Ah! Revive the Fallen. There you go. And you're standing right next to him, so.
Freros, sir.
Nice. Did he cast that? Is he up? Yes. So that didn't work on him? He's still at zero. Or did he get interrupted? Palagina, lay on hands. Adair. Just making sure he's not using, he's using his sword, not his bare hands. Keep up with the healing here.
Novel.
Oh my god. Oh, he's down. Durance is down. Crap. Aloth, Durance, and Canna. I think we're doomed. And now, Theodos is down. Oh, it's been real, guys. Major endurance.
But then roar.
This would be funny if this actually works. Oh yeah, he's not gonna be able to keep up.
Hey.
Take it.
Rifulikna.
Ah. That was fun. You know what I'm thinking? Next time we will try just focusing completely on Thaos. And, healing. We'll try to keep him away from our healer and magic user. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Next time you see this, I'll have won in some way. I don't want you guys to see me fail over and over again. So thanks again, and see you in the next episode. And enduring, go strong.